breathe, breathe in the air. Set your intentions, dream with care. Tomorrow's a new day for everyone.
I'd like to begin our assembly by acknowledging the traditional custodians of the land that we have gathered on today and recognize their continuing connection to land, waters, and community.
I'd like to pay my respects to the elders past, present, and emerging, for they hold the memories, the visions, the culture, and hopes of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander peoples across the nation.
Could you please stand silently for the Australian National Anthem? This year, NAIDOC Week 2020 has been postponed until November 8th. However, we can still take the time to acknowledge and celebrate our nation's first people. The theme for NAIDOC 2020 is always was, always will be, which recognises that First Nations people have occupied and cared for this continent for over 65,000 years and invites all Australians to embrace and acknowledge the true history of this country. A history which dates back to thousands of generations.
In Aboriginal culture, dancing and songs play an important role in storytelling and the passing down of knowledge from generation to generation. We are going to watch the two dances performed by Muju Mamba Creations in celebration of NAIDOC.
This dance we're about to perform is called the Yakul. Yakul in our Wurundjeri language actually means cold. Yakul means cold. And when we say Yakul, we always use the body language when we say cold. So this dance is about the coming of the southern clouds. So at this time, in winter time, Yakul season, when it's cold, the clouds come from up south and they bring new season with them. They bring new change to the earth. They also bring different laws within that seasonal time. So in winter time, I was taught that we never ate any freshwater animals. We never ate sand goanna, and we never ate budbud, a porcupine. So we didn't eat them things because they were having their babies. So we waited till the end of winter when they were still fat, but they'd already had their young, and then we would eat them things again. And this is knowledge that was passed on to me, my by my grandfather. So this dance is about the coming of the new season and the winter. The winter brings new change, it brings new seasonal change, it brings new berries, it brings new fruit, it brings new things that we can eat. In this dance, when we go like this, it represents the cleansing of the earth and the coming of new seasons. When we stomp our feet, it represents that connection we have with our ancestors and the earth. Because as you know, our ancestors have been stomping their feet on this earth for thousands and thousands of years. When we stomp our feet, we reconnect with our ancestors. When we go up to the left and come down, we're bringing all that goodness from that new season down to the earth, down to the Dandi, Mother Earth. We bring it from here and it comes down. So we're grabbing it and reaching it and pulling it down to the earth. When we go like this, brr, 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 hey, it represents our ancestors, our law people, and our spirit people. This action here represents our spirit people. This here represents our law people. And when they looked on the earth and they walked on this earth, they governed this earth. This dance is called Yakul, Yakul Mija. Bana. It's a rain dance. Every part of what we have on us has representation of our culture. So from our body paint, to the leaves, to our bubil, to our ngabil, and to our kuru. And it all represents where we come from and our cultural groups. The V's on my chest represent the scars from my ancestors on my father's side, the Iman people. So everything has a meaning.
Remember how very important our spirit values are here at Foxwell. So remember, they start with service, perseverance, integrity, research and responsibility, inclusivity, and teamwork. And this fortnight, we are very much focusing on inclusivity. And when we talk about inclusivity, it's about acknowledging and respecting different people and their differences. That may be that they're different because of their gender to you, their race, their family background, their interests, what they like to do on the weekends, their appearance. Everybody is different in their own way, and we know that by our own fingerprints, how very, very different we are, but we're all special in our own way. And something that I absolutely admire about our students here at Foxwell, and our staff and our parents, is that we celebrate that diversity, and we don't see that as a negative. We see that it's something to always celebrate every day. So I'm glad there's going to be many presentations today about inclusivity. Today is a very big and important day for some of our ambassadors. You know, we have four ambassadors, and today we've got a number of them leading our assemblies, and I thank Riley and Sid, and later on today, Yo-Yo, for doing that. And also a very big thank you and congratulations to Ethan and Jai, who paid respect to our Indigenous connections, and very, very proud of the boys for doing that. So thank you, boys. That was a very special moment. Last night, we had our parent-teacher interviews. And I walked around and listened to many of the conversations that the students, their parents, and their teachers were having. And it truly was a three-way learning partnership, where it wasn't just the teacher telling your parents how you've been doing. It was about the students owning their own learning, owning their learning goals, and knowing what their next steps for improvement were. I need you to keep doing that in class, talking to your teachers, seeking feedback. We're all on an improvement journey. Me as a principal, and your teachers, your parents, and each one of you are trying to always improve. Something that I truly believe in is that we should never accept mediocrity or never accept average. Never be ordinary. I challenge each and every one of you to always be extraordinary in everything that you do. And the only way you can do that is always looking for your next learning goal. What can I achieve next? And be really proud of that. Many of you had some wonderful report cards that you were very, very proud of and had some incredible improvements. So for those of you who've done that, congratulations. For those of you who need a little bit more motivation, look within for that. We don't need our parents and our teachers to be the one motivating us. We need to look in ourselves and go, I need to be better for myself. Now, I'd like to introduce and welcome to the stage a number of new staff members. Some of them have been here a little while now, but this is actually their very, very first assembly. So I'd like to introduce them to our school community. And the first one of those is our Deputy Principal, Ms. Nicholas. Please give her a wonderful Foxwell welcome. As Ms. Nicholas is coming up, I'd like to welcome Ms. Wilson, Ms. Raven, Ms. Wells, Ms. Jones, and Ms. Dalziel. We all know how wonderful Foxwell is, and we all know that it's a wonderful place to come 5 days out of most weeks. And it was an absolute choice of these teachers to come to our great school. They've heard so many wonderful things about our students, but it's an honour to have such brilliant educators with us. So a really loud welcome and round of applause for our time. Thank you very much. Okay, so I'm going to pass that to our leaders now. Thank you again. Remembering every time, I want to leave you with the message, which kindness is the Foxwell way. Thank you, everybody.
Acknowledging the commitment we make as students at Foxwell State Secondary College to value diversity and inclusivity.
Thank you.
stand silently and join Riley and I as we make our pledge. Please speak each part of the pledge as it appears on the screen.
I'm alive, and oh, I can fly. watch progress, y'all. I beat it for my mama. I told her when I was younger that I'ma be that number one. Yep, I'll be that number one. I take it higher and higher, higher and higher. I stay on fire, tire. Keep burning like that fire. Fire, fire. Whatever doesn't kill you only makes you stronger. So I'ma get stronger. Coming like a battering, battering. I'm knocking, knocking.